Are you an animal lover? Do you ever feel like you have so many pets that you're living in a zoo? Jules Feiffer knows exactly how you feel. Jules Feiffer is a famous children's author who has won multiple awards for his cartoons, plays, and screenplays. Some of his works include The Man in the Ceiling, Bark George, The House Across the Street, A Room with the Zoo, and many more. A Room with the Zoo was based upon true events that occurred in Jules' life with a little extra spin on things, making it more interesting for readers. Jules' 9-year-old adopted daughter, Julie, absolutely loved animals and planned on becoming a zookeeper or a veterinarian someday. Julie really did have a number of animals, making her room like a zoo. Julie's passion for animals takes over her life as well as her family's. Julie really wants a pet, especially a dog. First off, her mom dislikes animals, and secondly, her parents say she isn't old enough to have a dog. Dogs need a lot of care and attention. They need fed, played with, and walked. According to Julie's parents, she isn't old enough to walk a dog, therefore she's not allowed to have one. They were trying to decide on an age, but they couldn't, so instead Julie suggested a cat. She figured they couldn't deny a cat because they don't need to be walked. Julie and her dad picked out a kitten from the animal shelter named Timmy. Timmy was very sick with a cold when they got him. Julie's dad called the vet several times, and with several visits, he got better. After Timmy got better, Timmy acted like a completely different cat, and Timmy would always run and hide from Julie. Therefore, Julie was mad, and Julie wanted a new pet. Julie and her dad went to the pet store so they could get a hamster. She named him Hammy. Julie wasn't satisfied with Hammy because she was afraid Timmy would eat her hamster. So a few days later, Julie's dad went out and got a fish to occupy Timmy. Julie named him Oscar. Since a fish isn't much of a pet, Julie decided Oscar needed company. Therefore, Haley, Julie's sister, went to the pet store to get three goldfish. Oscar ate one of them overnight, though, and Julie was so upset. Her mom suggested they get a new pet to take her mind off the tragedy. Her mom got her a turtle named Tortellini. Spring break was coming up on us, and Julie really wanted to take Butch the class bunny home, but unfortunately, she wasn't selected. Although she was disappointed about not getting selected, she knew spring break would be fun since Julie and her family were going to see her stepsister Kate in Massachusetts. After a long day of driving, they finally arrived at Kate's house, where Kate, her husband Chris, and daughter Maddie were there to greet them. The next day, they went to the nearby farm so Maddie could see the goats, horses, pigs, and cows. Before they left the farm, Kate and Maddie spotted a new kitten, though. The farm owners were there trying to find new homes for the kittens, so they offered one to Kate. Kate took it home and gave it to Julie. Julie was so excited she named him Jesse. After the family arrived back home, Julie started slipping on her responsibilities of taking care of the pets. Therefore, her dad was trying to help her, and he injured himself when carrying Oscar's tank into the bathroom. He landed in the bathtub, and Oscar landed in the toilet. As Julie was chasing the animals around the house, they were breaking vases, knocking over bookshelves, and everything else. The entire living room was a disaster. Their mom was mad. The broken glass from one of the flower vases cut open Julie's leg, and she had to go to the hospital. After the stitches, they arrived back home to find the house was a mess, and Hammy must have been eaten by Jesse, and Oscar was still flopping in the toilet. The mom saved Oscar by putting him back into the clean tank. Julie's parents told her she could get another hamster to replace Hammy, but she didn't want a hamster because of all the memories. She was thinking about getting a gerbil instead. On the way to the pet store the next morning, they ran into some Chihuahua puppies on the elevator. Her dad told her she could get a puppy instead. They told her she was so brave through all the stitches and showing responsibility that she could now have a dog. She picked one and named him Stitches. Julie had finally gotten the puppy she'd always wanted, and now she's living happily ever after in her room, better known as the zoo.